Hey, I want to talk about one of my very favorite subjects, and that is shortened songs for the spotlight dances. So first dance, parents dances, can be some other things too, but essentially those two things. So I love the pushback that I get on this sometimes, and the pushback basically is this. It's their special moment. It's the first dance together as husband and wife. Why would you want to shorten that? They should, you know, they deserve the entire song. You know, that's a, frankly, I think a short-sighted answer. The song was recorded as a piece of art that is to be played on an album, a CD, on the radio, performed in concert, not specifically as a moment for a father-daughter dance or for a first dance. So what we're really trying to do now is we're creating this really great moment. Well, how long is a moment? It's different for everybody, right? Is 3 minutes and 48 seconds the correct length for this moment? Or is it 2:28? Or is it 7:28? So let me give you an extreme example. For those who think you should never shorten the song, it should be the full length, whatever it was recorded. What if the song that they chose was 9.5 minutes and the whole time they just did this dance, right? A little slow, rock back and forth. Would you say maybe that's too long? Okay, so assuming you agreed to that, then we're in agreement that the length of the song is arbitrary to what the moment is. So how do you decide what the right length is? Well, there's a lot of factors. One is, as simple as this, you know, what are the bride and groom going to do? If they're going to just do this for the entire time, man, from their perspective, they're probably not loving the spotlight. Secondarily, from the guest perspective, this is a moment, right? This is a romantic moment that they're all involved in. Man, I don't know that I could watch this for 4 minutes, right? And what you see is, begin observing. Next time you do a first dance, watch what happens at the 2 minute mark. Watch the guests at the 2:30 mark. Watch the guests at the 3 minute mark. And then after 3 minutes, man, you see more conversations going on. People turn away. They're sort of losing all of that focus. You've lost the moment. The moment was powerful. It should have been the highlight of the night. And it went on too long, right? It's like, think about a toast. If a 3 minute toast is good, is a 5 minute toast necessarily better? It might be. But it might not be. So how do I determine how long the first dance is going to be? Well, there's a lot of factors. First, what are they doing, right? So if they're just doing this, not much. But if it's a choreographed dance, we can watch that much longer because there's more to see. If there's a video playing in the background while they dance, it can go a little bit longer, right? Because there's more to see. If the wedding party is coming out to join them partway through, then that can be longer. So there's a lot of different factors that come into it. Same thing with the father-daughter dance. I have this really great video of a DJ here in Sacramento, and he's doing butterfly kisses for the father-daughter dance. And early on in the video, the father already makes a point about not liking the spotlight. And now he comes out to do the father-daughter dance. And gosh, that's a long song. It's 5 minutes long. A couple minutes into the song, they're starting to kind of get goofy on the dance and they don't know what to do. And at one point, the videographer happens to be set up right next to the DJ. And so she looks at the DJ, but it looks like she's looking right into the camera. And as she's dancing with her dad, this incredible, amazing moment, she looks at her dad and she goes, right? That's how her father-daughter dance ends. It went too long. It's too long of a song. But here's what happened. The bride said butterfly kisses. The DJ said, okay. And he played butterfly kisses. Not his fault, right? I hear a lot of DJs say, well, I just tell the client, give me a signal, tug on your ear or something when you want me to quit. It's just the worst possible scenario for so many reasons. First off, she isn't qualified to know when the guests are losing interest. Second, even if she was, you're asking her to get out of the moment with her dad into that moment and tell you how to do your job. Really inappropriate. So let's say she does all that anyway. And she turns to you and she gives you the little tug on the ear. And she does that, of course, because you know how this works. She does that right as it's about to go into the chorus, just as the last chorus begins. And now you've got the big chorus ending. So now you're going to fade out of the song, which will sound like you faded out of the father-daughter song, or you faded out of the first dance song. It's horrible. Or do you go, not a good time to fade out. I'm going to keep going. Now she's like, you know, tugging her ear like Carol Burnett, right? Like, it's too much. Don't put that on them. Make them a short edit. If you don't know how to do it, we cover it in great detail on Volume 5, how they do that, of the 1% solution. Very specific instructions, and it's like really super, super easy to do that. In fact, I've shared a lot of my short edits that I've made with people, and if you're ever in a bind and you want to do this, and just shoot me a message, go on our Facebook group, 1%solution.com, and let me know. If it's a song that, you know, you send me the original, so I know you have it, I'll send you the shortened version. And you can use it. And I've got every song ever done at this point. I've been doing this for 20 years of shortening songs. So pretty rare that I have to make a new edit for them anymore. So the length of time is 2 minutes, right? That's a good length of time. It's kind of like this. If you get the length just right, you'll have people there to the very end. Let's say there was something you were watching on YouTube and it said, oh, a minute with Randy Bartlett. And 6 minutes later, you're still watching the video covering the same thing. Some of you have tuned out. Pay attention. I'm wrapping this up now. All right. So make the moment count. Give them that big ending. Don't fade out of the song. It sounds like you're fading out. It sounds like you've lost interest. Make sure you keep the ending of the song, especially if it has a powerful ending. If it's just got a fade ending anyway, it's not as big of a deal, but easy to do. I'm telling you, your brides and grooms will love it. I will tell you this, for 20 years, I've been offering this to my clients, and I would bet 95% of them choose short edits on their songs, unless it's a song like, you know, Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong, which is already really short. But it's very rare that somebody chooses a full-length version. And if they're not sure, I just give them an edited version and a full-length version. And I go, dance someone home, let me know. Well, 100% of the time when that happens, they're like, oh, that was way too long. Frequently, I give them two or three different versions. You know, I have a client coming up, and we gave them one where there were I left both verses in, but I took out a chorus, and I took a verse out on one, and I left two choruses, a couple of different variations. They liked the verses, so we did that. So the version they chose was a little bit longer than what they wanted it to be, but it was still under about 2:32 or something that they chose. For me, 2 minutes to 2:15, that's kind of the perfect length. Shorter than that, feels a little short. You can go to 1:45. Anything under that, I think, feels too short. Anything over 3 minutes is just too much. Much like this video, which just hit the 8-minute mark. See you later.